Now we're going to create a console application that writes the current time to a binary file and later reads it back and displays it to the console. I'm going to create two methods, the saveCurrentTime method and the showPreviousTime method. I will call each of these methods from the main routine. Then in the main routine, I'm also going to call console.readKey just to pause the display. So in saveCurrentTime, as you might recall from the course, the first thing I need to do is to create a file stream object. This file stream object is required to create the binary writer object that I'll need to write it with. Of course, file stream requires the system.io namespace. So when you create the file stream object, you specify the file name. I'm just specifying a name here, which will drop it in the same directory, the default directory, which is the directory the assembly is running from. You could, of course, specify a full path. Notice that the binary writer constructor here takes the file stream object as a parameter. Now I can make write calls to the binary writer instance, but notice that there's no write override for writing a full date time object. So I can't write an entire dateTime.now object. I can, however, write integers. So what I've done is I write dateTime.now.hour, which is an integer, and dateTime.now.minute, which is an integer. Then I close both the file stream and the binary writer. So when I go to read it, I need to read it in the exact same order. I would get an error if I were to, say, try to read a double. So again, I need to create a file stream object, only this time, instead of specifying the filemode.create parameter, I just open it for reading. Instead of creating a binary writer object, I create a binary reader object. But basically, reading is exactly the same as writing. So now I'm creating a string called previous time, and I'm going to create it by reading in the hours and minutes from the binary file. Now, when I wrote, I could use the overridden write method and add in any of these supported types. But when I read, I have to specify the type, so I have to call readInt32 for both the hours and minutes. There's also read methods for doubles and longs and character arrays and a variety of other types, but as I said, not daytime. So now I can run this, and you'll see it writes the time, 4:33 p.m., and then reads it back.